Hey there, everyone. welcome back to Alan Wake. I'm Rain Redgrave, and we're starting off from where I just left. PlayStation kicking up again. Jeez. You're only rendering the death. Hi. Oh! Oh, did I pick that up? Whoopsies. Other than a minute. So, yeah. Barrett revolver, yes. Can't go over there. Oh. Shall we have a little...
The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
Nice.
Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now, she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was literally the high point of her life. She watched as he got in the car with his wife. She was pretty, confident, at ease with Wake. Not like Rose. They were perfect for each other. She'd have given anything to be called their friend.
It's a little sad. Whoa. Sorry, I actually jumped when it did that. Fucking hell. Ooh. Flashbacks? We having flashbacks? Oh, I suppose that sound does blend in with the, whatever this is.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Here to tell you, I'm looking at the water. Okay. Alright. We're gonna look ahead. We're not gonna drop in the water. We're gonna look ahead. We're looking ahead. We're looking. Yes! If you can go there, why not? Oh! Thermos. Flask, thermos. They're just different names, aren't they? What is that? Where are they? Oh.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Yeah, Stucky got problems. Let me check, yeah. Got a revolver handy. Oh, nice. Although when games give you stuff, it normally means... Yeah, you're gonna be fighting. Sorry, I know there's a path there, I just have a habit of having a little look around to see if there's anything... Oh, fuck! Bitch! Oh, fuck! Jesus! You two ever take a break? Oh, I can't see. I'm in a bush. Tree. Thing. Oh, God. Oh, fuck. Alan, run. Run, 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 run! Oh. I died. No. Run toward the light. Where's the... Oh, for fuck's sake, I dodged! Oh, fine. Oh, back, 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 back. I'm gonna die again. That's what I wanted. Where's the asshole? Did he die too? Oh, I hope he died. I see some lights up there. Yeah. Not my best moment. Oh. I'm not gonna pass up some good stuff. Can you hear breathing? I hear some breathing. You can hear breathing, right? Like just someone breathing close to your ear or something. Kinda creepy. Okay, I guess I'm going back down. Alright, down. Can we go back? Yeah, go down the ladder. I don't want you breaking your ankles. Just realized that this equips anything you just pick up.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
Puzzle time? Is it puzzle time?
I couldn't stay here. There had to be a way to get up there.
Well, there's a way. We'll just have to find it. Oh. All
the stairs were useless. I had to find something else to help me climb up there. There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Now we're looking for a generator. Man, this is... Ah! So being up here did have some use. Where's the ladder? I don't want to jump down and break his ankles.
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top.
There is. It's just Was that me or something else? Oh, bugger, fuck, no. Oh! Oh, the light fell your damn soul. What does this one say?
I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
Ooh, a shotgun. I'm gonna bloody need it, aren't I? Wrong button.
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top.
Well, there's probably something. Well, that's powered. Huh. I've probably got a ton of stuff I need to find, collect, and whatnot. But for now, I have to manually do this. I mean, that should do it, right? It should. If it doesn't, bugger. I don't know, just change to the revolver for now, pal. What's that? Oh! Sorry, you know the deal. You see the shiny, you can get the shiny, go get the shiny. Don't for the life of me know what the shiny does, but... or if it does anything at all. Just realize it swings. The guard, my neighbor moving around. Ooh, shotgun.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. As you listeners know, I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and it would keep you company all night long if I weren't. It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walk.
Mm-hmm. Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find him.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him from...
Toby's a friendly dog?
Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but he's just too dumb for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks, Pat.
You have a good night now.
Hey, doggy. My doggy's lost. Oh, okay. Nice.
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy, or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
And who doesn't want to save Alice? I see a glint in
the gas station was closer now. Its light welcoming in the darkness.
Great stuff. What now? Oh my god. These bastards out here. Oh no. Oh, I keep pressing the the wrong button. Oh god, what am I like? Alright. Let me try and get my dodge on point here. Oh. Going this way, aren't I? I saw something. Oh fuck. Alright. I saw something. Oh, fuck. Bolt, pal. Bolt. Ever take a break? Oh, for fuck's sake. Run! Oh my god, why? I'm not doing that great.
Garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess.
I'm still learning.
It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
Kind of interrupted that. Sorry.
Mm-hmm.
be more, isn't there? It's the only reason you give me stuff. What? Oh, fuck off. What was that? Great. Because I have absolutely no fucking clue if I'm gonna manage. Maybe we should keep that on me right now. Because I have a feeling there's gonna be more than one. There's like a spider over there. Let's see a page. I'm sure I just saw somebody running off to the right, but what can I say?
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help, but I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Oh, banging around outside. Well, this time it didn't give me a fright, but oh, I'm a fool. What's this?
Science. Oh. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton. Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed.
Huh?
Night Springs. Tonight's episode, a quantum suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing
Uh-oh.
Did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality! Dr. Colvin, felled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. In Night Springs.
So the game has a TV show. Cool. Don't know what that does, but oh boy. Something. Let me go. Fuck. I backed into something and I just cornered myself. Okay. Now that I kinda know what's there, maybe I'll... Oh, he's too quick. Oh, that asshole is too quick. Oh, boy. He's there. There's a problem? Oh, I'm gonna open it. Just hit it. Dead. Jesus.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reached the lights at the gas station alive.
Yeah. Well, with them gone, I can take a little wander around, right? I mean, there's opportunity for hidden stuff. what's the creaking of the logs in that thing. Jeez. I'm just sort of, I'm having one of those moments, I'm getting used to everything in this, and all I can think of is, oh shit. You would think a place full of light is okay. Would be quite safe.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
It's a deer.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
Brilliant. Hello, Mr. Page.
Stucky spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling, caught his attention. Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before him. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him.
Let's see. What if I can just press the other button? We'll take memory out.
The deer fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
You're missing a week? Jeez. Me personally, I've only ever missed a few hours.
I had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help.
I'll get your phone in a minute, pal. It's just, I kind of want to look around. You know? Because it looks like I can go places. Kinda. Can I go there? It looks kind of shut off, so maybe. Maybe I can't. Okay, maybe not. Maybe not. That noise is scary. It scares the fan on that thing over there kicking up as soon as it's like, hey, guess what? Boom. I'm a fan.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Oh.
All right. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Maybe? 68th Annual Deer Fest. September 15th to the 18th. Games and activities, raffle tickets, fishing competition, pie contest, surprise competitions, live music. Can be that. For the kids, it's Bucktoothed Charlie. Okay. Montgomery, the Mystics, Amazing Phantasmagoria. That's in the evenings. and a parade. Well, don't that sound lovely? Sounds nice. You answered the phone, I believe.
Bright Ball Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head.
Oof.
Are you okay?
No.
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Clown, they call the Sandman, tiptoes to my room every night.
Damn.
Just to sprinkle stardust and to whisper, go to sleep, everything is all right. I close my eyes.
Well,
then I drift away.
End of episode one.
Into the magic night. Softly say,
oh, here's some music for you.
Like
right.
Do. Then I fall asleep to dream.
I believe this is the end of the episode for me.
In dreams, I walk
so.
With you.
Sorry, I'm just laughing at that music.
In dreams I talk.
Thank you very much for watching. I hope you're having a great day, night, whatever time it is, where you are. Hope you're all well. And I'll see you very, very soon. Bye now.